This is EA Sports PGA Tour coverage coming up next. Rich Lerner alongside Frank Nabilo set to call all the action here at the Wells Fargo Championship. We are at Quail Hollow, and Frank, it is really one of the best courses on tour.
It is. Great state of North Carolina, where Donna Ross developed so many great courses. They're the sort of courses that we're used to seeing, but this is a relatively new golf course. First opened up in 1961, but it certainly fits in with the North Carolina landscape. Mature trees, holes well cut out. Beautiful greens and interesting finish.
How do you like that finishing stretch? They call it the green mile.
Some might think it's purgatory, but I think it's the perfect touch to a great golf course.
Now the approach shot here at the par 4 first.
There's a big mound in the middle of this green, Rich, and the ball has a tendency to kick either side of that. So just be aware.
See if he can go one better than yesterday when he made par. This putt for birdie.
And a great start.
Frank, a nice mix of opening holes here at Quail Hollow and the Wells Fargo Championship. Pretty short par three here at the second.
180-yard shot. We'll play more like 175 for the half a club downhill. There's much more green on that right side. If you're not too sure what club to hit, then you should stay away from that left side.
This one looks right on point. That will be a great look at birdie. Frank going for another birdie here.
Just to get on a real roll.
Has it for another birdie. Two holes, two birdies. Frank, here at the third, players facing a challenging tee shot.
For a number of reasons, Rich. One, that the hole bends to the left. Two, that the fairway starts to run out. And three, the length of the second shot. You get rewarded the better you hit your tee shot down here. Long and straight.
That's how you do it.
Oh, that's got to be 300 yards, isn't it?
Players aren't just grabbing any old golf club these days, Frank. It's about spin rate and launch angle and all of those sorts of concepts.
Yeah, and the grooves. All those things help the player. Even the loft on wedges now. Loft has increased. We now see 64, 65 degree sand irons, so they get the ball up quicker and it stops quicker.
Good swing, good shot yet again. Wow, Frank, he is dialed in.
Yeah, that was just some shot on that. Easy birdie.
This for another birdie on this hole on the week. No problems early. Looks good.
Does look good. This bodes well. We might be in for a very, very low round today.
Now to the fourth hole here at Quail Hollow, just under 490 yards.
Yeah, they used to have the tee on the right side, which actually made that tee shot very uncomfortable. When they put the new tee box in on the left side, it's a little easier to hit that fairway because that fairway slopes from right to left.
Frank, that's as good as I have seen all day long.
I think we've got to blame that on the weather. That weather, the wind had to help that ball, give it another 20, 30 yards.
This is position A, right in the fairway, and 180 yards to go. Yeah.
Had a birdie here yesterday in their close. Great opportunity for another one. Not a gimme, but well within his range.
Rich, that just adds insult to injury to the rest of the field. Another birdie, and the gap even wider.
A sensational performance.
Frank, in today's modern game where players are hitting it so far, I always feel like one of the more exciting holes is a reachable par five, and here we are at the fifth, 570 yards.
Yeah, this is reachable, providing you hit a good drive. Otherwise, it becomes very awkward on the layup, sort of often threading the ball out of trees and just trying to find you some sort of third shot. So to your point, big advantage with a good tee shot here.
Well, not this time. That one's in the rough. Might be a tough shot coming up.
Ends up in the first cut, and he'll have a pretty good look at the hole location from here.
This is a good-looking shot.
Big swing right there, and a great result. And now a chance for a big swing in momentum with an eagle coming up.
Wow, Nate's eagle makes everybody else look sort of average, Frank.
And look at the size of that lead on the leaderboard now.
Frank, this is where you know that players like Bubba Watson, Dustin Johnson, Rory McIlroy are playing a different game than guys like me. They step up to this 250-yard par 3, and they might hit a 5-iron. It is a little downhill, but they might be with a middle iron where a lot of us would be with a driver.
Well, you see the advantage of that power on this very hole, not just because of the length they got to hit it, but the green they're heading into. This green slopes off in both directions, right and left, so you have to land that ball in the middle of the green. So, yeah, it's a big advantage if you can go at this hole with like a 5-iron.
Frank putting it all together today. What a nice performance.
It's been like a clinic so far.
Seems to like it.
Looks like it's
headed for the green.
Put a birdie on the card here yesterday, don't forget.
Trying to make yet another birdie.
It's amazing. Doesn't matter how close it goes. It's an extra shot. That one will definitely hurt.
Locked in on the read and the speed. Just an amazing display. The records continue to fall.
Frank, there's a lot to chew on here as you get to the tee at the 532-yard par 5 7th.
In today's game, 530 plus change you think is incredibly short. And look at the trouble in front of you. Water all the way down the right side and around that right side of the green. Bunkers left. This is not for the faint of heart. What a great shot.
They'll be happy with that. In the fairway, now a good chance to attack this hole.
Frank, here we are at another par five. Second shot to the seventh. Is it time to go pedal to the metal?
Yeah, this is the shortest of the four par fives, and this is second shot has to be respected. Left, obviously, isn't ideal, but it's still better than letting the ball go to the right.
Appears to be a smart shot, Frank.
Yeah, no problem here. That's going to fly all the way.
That is impressive. Hit every single green in regulation today. Well done. And he's putting for eagle now. He got robbed, Frank.
No, it's like kissing your mother-in-law.
Nudge this one home. Finish it up. Continues to amaze. Yet another birdie. And what a day it's been.
Frank, I love a drivable par four. In the modern power game, it really adds an element of excitement. And here we go at the 350-yard par 4/8.
Well, you're definitely going to love this one then, Rich, because it ticks all the boxes here. There's no water in play, just a few bunkers down the left and the one that protects the right side of the green. And you've got a really narrow green, so plenty of reward with minimal risk.
Drivable par 4, not for most in this field, but for this guy, yes, he has just knocked it on. What a shot. Right off the edge. Wow.
That hurts.
He really likes this hole. Made birdie yesterday. Can he do it again today?
You get the sense now with that birdie that our young star, so explosive, is setting himself up for a big weekend run. Well, Frank, what do you think of the ninth hole here at Quail Hollow?
Oh, I think it's a beauty, Rich. One of those long, nice drawing tee shots. 500 yards is a par four. You have to hit a good drive down there. The fairway doesn't camber that much. Hole does dogleg to the left. Big advantage for a big tee shot here.
See if our featured golfer can get a little something positive going here, Frank. It has been a miserable day.
Yeah, things have just appeared too tough. So really just somehow just eradicate everything you've been thinking right now. Realize this green's big enough. Just get something on the green. Opportunity maybe for a birdie.
Good chance now for a birdie. That was an outstanding play.
Well, it's almost a guarantee there after that shot.
You'll love them. The birdies, and that's another one. Just a superb performance on the front side. He's hoping to keep it going here on the back nine, Frank.
The game is so much easier when you're swinging well, putts are going in. Really, you've just got to keep out of your own way. Rich, right now, this does not look like the same player we saw earlier on in the day.
I don't recognize him. He was hitting it all over the ballpark in the first few holes. I didn't think there was any chance that he'd be where he is right now. Credit to him. This took guts.
Yeah, his composure is so different right now.
Well, that's the beauty of this game. You stay with it. It's 18 holes. You keep fighting, and you can put a score on the card.
happiness is a long, 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 long walk after that one.
Looks like he's going to have a go at it here at the par five, his second shot. Oh, it looked like he caught a flyer right there, Frank.
Well, I don't know what he caught, but this is way too much.
Wow, lucky break right there, Frank.
Yeah. That's what everyone else is going to say, except him.
This is a nine-footer. What a tremendous display of golf this has been. Frank, on this backside at Quail Hollow, a player does have a good chance to get off to a good start with that par 5 10th and now a relatively short par 4 11th, where a player with a good drive could stick a short iron in their hands.
Yeah, this is one you're going to have to make a decision. You can just play this as a straightforward dogleg left par 4 and hit a 3-wood or a long iron up there and, you know, 9-iron or something like that into the green. Or, if you want to, you can try and blast a drive around the corner. I don't know if that's the more prudent play, but it's fun.
Frank, what has stood out for you watching this player into these wins?
A lot of smart decisions. Not trying to fight the wind, using it, and really just a lot of good strikes, one after the other. Long and straight.
That's how you do it. And now it's right in his wheelhouse, good position where he can attack the pin.
Yeah, he has all those options now. That ball's sitting up, you can bring it in high, you can bring it in low. The choice is yours.
This one looks like it's headed right for the middle of the dance floor, Frank.
Rather nice shot, I would say.
Oh, can't hide the flag stick from that man. Will we try again here today? Just singes the edge, Frank.
Yeah, but at least he's burning the edges. You know you're hitting good parts.
So, they'll tap in. Nothing wrong with that par putt. Par 4 12th here at Quail Hollow, 456 yards. Frank, break it down for us.
Well, there's no fairway bunkers either side, so you feel like there's nothing to work the ball off, and consequently, it's very easy to sneak it in the rough on the left or the right, and then that makes that second shot so much more difficult going up the hill. This is one hole that you have to pick a line on. You really have to know your line off the tee. There's a nice big tree down there in the distance. That's the one you want to work it off.
What a tremendous display of power and precision. Boy, this is a challenging second shot here to the par 4 12th.
It's almost like two greens, Rich. That ridge that goes through the middle about the halfway point, 18 to 20 yards. Anything over that will kick on, and anything short of that runs back to the front.
Playing this par four, still not on the green after that second shot.
But still not done. A good third shot, maybe get away here with par. Not a problem there, Rich.
Been pretty good all day from this distance, just trying to take care of business.
And he has it.
A good putt redeems all.
Now to the par 3, 13th hole. Frank, this one, 210 yards.
Very, very good par 3. This is actually a big green. It's 37 yards deep, but it actually plays small. Has a front right portion. There's a roll-off area in the middle, and there's a roll-off area in the back. So don't be deceived by the size of this green. You better be pitching that tee shot right bang in the middle.
I like the looks of this one. Is a beauty, a real beauty. Par yesterday, and for birdie.
Great, too.
Beautiful.
Wow, Frank, this is a really good little par four, isn't it, the 14th?
It is, and this is where one of those strong three woods comes in. The last 50 or 60 yards, is the ball kicks down and towards the left, and it sounds like an aggressive play, but like a hard three wood trying to run it down there is actually not a bad play.
Is it drivable?
It is drivable, but it's whether it's worth the risk.
What a display of power and precision off the tee. On the green here on the par four, in one. Frank, he might like this one. He might like do that. What a putt. Now as we arrive at the par 5, 15th hole here at Quail Hollow, 577 yards, Frank, I think a player has to be thinking about doing what Rory McIlroy did in 2010.
It's the last of the holes that you can really be aggressive on, Rich. So a good drive down here. I'm well aware of the fact that there's water on the left. This is a good chance to make something happen before you play the green mile.
And that's what McIlroy did. Hit a tracer, then a 5-iron, knocked it in for eagle, shot 62, and won for the first time on the PGA Tour. Now the all-important approach to this, the final par 5 at Quail Hollow.
This looks like it's going to find the target.
And a chance for eagle after that perfectly played shot. Frank, it's one thing to jumpstart your round. This would ignite the round.
Yeah, you don't normally see two par fives back to back. So the chances of having consecutive eagles is so rare.
That had to really hurt, Frank, because it looked good all the way.
Well, this will test his mettle.
Just a little tap in here. Wow, what a birdie.
And
This is the start of what some say is the toughest finishing stretch on the PGA Tour. It's known as the Green Mile. Frank, what makes it so challenging?
Well, this hole in particular, Rich, the dogleg right, it means it plays every inch of its just over 500 yards. That bunker you can see down the right, 325 yards to carry that. If you can fly the ball that far, at least you can chew off two-thirds of this hole, and that is well required here. Otherwise, it's a long, long second shot.
You knew it right away. Picked up the tee, didn't even look at it. We can see it. It's perfect, right down the middle of the fairway. And he's set up for his second shot here, looking to knock it on the green. That is an excellent play right there. The approach, giving him another good look. Standing over this putt, concentrating on the read. Oh, man.
I just pushed it.
Boy, that hurts. Just a couple of feet.
Dwindling the holes down. Pars are fine right now.
Frank, this is all you want in a par three, especially late in the round. You have to carry the water. You have to deal with the pressure. At 221 yards, this requires a player's very best.
On the process of elimination, don't go long, don't go left, don't go short, and right is marginal. It doesn't leave you with much.
This could be a good one. Just a case of a hole suiting the player's eye. Made the birdie yesterday, and he has a good chance to make another one today. Birdie here yesterday, trying to do it again today. Just an amazing display. The records continue to fall. Here we are, the 18th hole at Quail Hollow. Simply put, Frank, a player needs to hit maybe his best tee shot of the day.
I would agree with you, Rich. If you were to measure this hole from trees on the left to trees on the right, it's actually a really wide fairway or expansive land. But that creek that just meanders its way through the middle of this hole completely changes the nature of this hole. And consequently, you hit the nail on the head. If you don't hit a good tee shot, you will rack up something here. And I've got no idea how big it would be.
Good swing, good shot yet again. So maybe a nice way to finish up with a good approach here to the 18th and a good chance for birdie. Now this for birdie came away with par in the previous round. Continues to amaze, yet another birdie, and what a day it's been. There you have it. The second round is complete. Another solid effort put together, and it shows on the scorecard.
And after two rounds, you really start to see not only who's playing well, but who's consistent.